peace.
Your family? Friends?
They are back in Zealand. No need. I have the Light Elves whom love. Care for me now. Please. We are close. So close. From here, a final leg to this journey. Yes. Here. This is the path. The wind blew is across the Swan Road. I can see it. The river steed will be needed to cross. Careful now. We don't want to attract any unwanted attention from the Dark Elves. Oh, how they haunt me.
Best not to draw attention here.
There. That is Freyr's castle. He keeps court in there. Or did. Until the Dark Elves came.
Have your wind blew now, in peace, Oldringer.
Ah, yes. The realm is safe. For now. Hail, Drenger.
Sing us a song.
Run up the sail!
Survey the area, Sunan.
Thank you.
Let's go.
Sing, my ravens. We need an epic tale.
I knew a crazed man about my age called Rokur. We had taken to calling Rokur the Rodent for his habit of collecting axes. For 20 years, he collected axes of all make and size. He had never seen a day of battle, but he swore before that he would. In his 31st year, after drinking too much ale, Rokur seduced another man's wife. That man called a Holmgang against Rokur. Rokur accepted the Holmgang, and on the agreed-upon day, he laid out 12 of his axes and asked, "Which of these will I use to slay you? Will it be Bone Splitter?" he said. "My bearded blade inscribed with Sather runes, affixed to a handle of English oak, or Blood Fountain," he continued. "My Dane axe, which swings through the air on two hands with the speed of an arrow's flight. Or might it be Twin Wolf Wounder?" Rokur growled, growing even more bold. "Fierce pair of throwing axes." At that moment, the man who had challenged Rokur brought a large stone down upon his head. Rokur died instantly, and his axes were given away as gifts.
Stayed our welcome.
Let's hear a story.
Have I ever told you the story about...
I am fairly certain you have. Anyone else with a tale to share before Dag starts talking again?
Let's have a song.
Strain to Valhalla's pain. The
and horns resounds the mighty horn. For those who fight, for those who fall. For those who fight, for those who fall. Warlord weaves his
fortifications there, I want.
Each man gets his fated share of blood red surge, the warrior.
You found me out. I bow to this, but you will not unearth us all. You will not dig deeply enough. We are both a clot and cancer. We sit heavy in water, and yet we spread like a river's current.
Are you well?
Why would you ask such a question at such a time as this?
Beneath your words is something of a size unknown, a mystery. It lurks behind every frail word from your mouth.
Give up, you shit!
Aid me. Be my eyes.
Hey! Camp there, Eivor. Probably hostile. There. There! A military encampment!
Save it.
Eivor! What does he have there?
We must grow in these waters.
Take the mask off.
When needed.
Welcome to my kingdom, wandering lord. I seek an alliance, one to benefit us both.
This is your kingdom, you say?
Indeed it is, Northix. And I am its first and reigning king, Ekwald. And as sovereign, I seek a keen ally to secure my strength.
Kingdom. This island here.
Yes, from shore to shore. My brothers and I came upon this unclaimed land some months ago, and found it suited to our ambitions. Sadly, my brothers were drowned in a terrible squall soon after, along with our riches. There was an arm ring among them. To you, I offer this arm ring, in exchange for my loyalty. Find the ring among the wreck, and you may call a king your friend.
A good armoring can be as important as blood to the heart. If I find it, I will let you know. I found your arm ring amidst the wreckage of your ship.
By all that is great, I cannot believe my eyes and ears. Now you are pledged to the Kingdom of Northex. That will show him.
I am honored to forge an alliance with your stock, King Ekwald of Northex. Long may you reign.
Thank you. As you are pledged to me, I am pledged to you. If ever I have an army to lend, you may make use of it.
down here. Come on!
Sorry, made up?
Sing, my ravens. Who will share a tale?
Here's a tale to tickle your sides. Winter before, I was drinking in Stavanger with some companions. With us in the mead hall were men of Bard Jarl's clan, one of which was a poet named Halli, called Sarcastic Halli by most. 7 ale horns into his night, Halli stood upon his table and called across the room to another man. Skald named Chudolf. Chudolf! He yelled. I can compose a more beautiful poem with my belching than you could with your tongue and fine words.
No other man!
The room laughed. Chudolf loud.
Hold on, Gustav. Hold here.
I should be cautious around here. Go, Sunan.
My battle kennings have worn thin. I am no longer the reed among shields, the glimmer blood, the hallowed skull crack.
The scourge of Swanroads.
The Iron Throng. The lender of silver gelds. I only wish to be a freebooter. Someone who writes their own destiny.
Be glad you head to Valhalla with a poem on your lips.
Thank you. the other side.
Hey, fellas!
stretch your wing.